Section 6.1 is angles and their measure. I would pause the video and write down these notes. So we have an angle. We call the initial side this side that we start our measurement from, and our terminal side the side that we end our measurement from. Usually the initial side lands up with the vertex at the origin and the initial side on the positive x-axis, that's standard position. This inside, if we go counterclockwise, that's a positive measurement. If we go clockwise, that's a negative angle. We usually call angles, now that we're getting into trigonometry, we call them theta or some Greek letter. So here are some different types of angles as well as some different parts of angles or degrees. So go ahead and pause the video and write down these notes. So we want to convert between just degrees and degree, minute, and seconds. So this subdivisions of degrees that we talked about up here. So right now we have 50 degrees, 6 minutes, and 21 seconds, and we want to write that as just degrees. So when you're converting 6 minutes and 21 seconds, that's less than 1 degree. So when you want to write it as just a degree, you're going to have just 50 degrees, and then we're going to have some decimals on the end. So 6 minutes is 6/60th of a degree, and 21 seconds is 21/3600ths of a degree. So then if you plug this into your calculator, that will tell you what this is actually as a degree, and it ends up being 50.105 degrees. For the next one, we're going to go the opposite direction. We want to go from something that's just in degrees to something that's written in minutes, degrees, minutes, and seconds. So the 21, the whole number, like over here, that became the whole number of our degree. So going the opposite direction, the 21 is the full, that's the total number of degrees that have already been achieved. So that's just going to be our actual degree, and the decimal, the 0.256, is what becomes the minutes and seconds. So doing this, we need to do a little bit of unit conversion. So we're going to convert 0.256 degrees into minutes first, and then whatever we have decimalized left over the minutes, we'll convert that into seconds. But we're going to convert this into minutes. So for every 1 degree, there are 60 minutes. So if we do this, our degrees end up canceling, and then plug that into your calculator, and you get 15.36 minutes. For degrees and minutes, whenever we're writing something as degree, minutes, seconds, you should not have decimals. So we're just going to take the 15 part, and that's going to become our minutes. And then the 0.36 minutes, that becomes our seconds. So we're going to do another unit conversion. We have 0.36 minutes, and there are 60 seconds in every 1 minute, just like time. So then if you plug this into your calculator, you end up with 21.6 seconds, because the minutes cancel. For 8 seconds, now at this point we don't get anything smaller than seconds, so now we can have a decimal. So you can have 21.6 seconds. So 21.256 degrees is the same thing as 21 degrees, 15 minutes, and 21.6 seconds. Now we're going to talk about a new type of angle measurement, which is radians. In the past, pretty much we've always used degrees. Now we have a new type of angle measurement, which is called a radian. So one revolution, basically one circle, would be 360 degrees. In radians, it is 2 pi radians, okay? 2 pi radians. So we want to be able to convert between radians and degrees. So if we're converting between radians and degrees, it's just unit conversion. So we have 60 degrees, and there are 360 degrees for every 2 pi radians. So then you have degrees end up canceling. And then if you plug all this in, you end up with pi over 3 radians. So you just want to remember this conversion. 2 pi is equal to 360 degrees. 2 pi radians is 360 degrees. So go ahead and pause the video and do the 2, 3, and 4. Convert negative 45 degrees into radians, and then convert pi over 6 and negative 7 pi over 3 radians into degrees. So if we do the unit conversion, you'll see that I did pi over 180 instead of 2 pi over 360. It's those 2 and that 360 is always going to cancel, so you could just use pi over 180. If 2 pi is 360 degrees, then 1 pi is 180 degrees. So negative 45 degrees is the same thing as negative pi over 4 radians. The other direction, same thing now. We're going to have degrees on top because that's what we want to end up with, and radians has to be on the bottom to cancel with our radians. So the pi's cancel, you end up with 30 degrees. And then same thing here, you end up with negative 420 degrees. Make sure when it's a degree, you put the degree symbol, because if you don't have a unit, that is radians. Normally in radians, you will not actually write radians. It's just negative pi over 4, and that's known to be radians. So if you need degrees, make sure you write that degree symbol. That's your units. So we are going to be using radians almost exclusively from here on out. So make sure you know how to do this conversion. Another part of this is arc length. So we're talking about arc length here. So if you have a circle, okay, and you split up into an, you cut a piece of pi out of that circle of angle theta in radians, okay, your angle is always in angle radians, then we want to measure that basically crust of the pizza slice. That's arc length. So that is whatever your radius is times that angle in radians. Also, we want to find area of a sector, so basically area of that pizza slice. So same thing, theta is in radians, and then you have some radius r, and you're finding the area of that section, and it's 1/2 r squared theta. So what I want you to do is pause the video and find the area of a sector that has a central angle of 30 degrees and a radius of 2 feet, keeping in mind that these formulas always take theta in radians, so you're going to have to do some unit conversion first before you find the area. So we need to do a little unit conversion because we need theta in radians, but they give us in degrees. So 30 degrees is the same thing as pi over 6 radians. And then I just plug this into the formula, 1/2 2 squared times pi over 6, and you end up with pi over 3 feet squared. Make sure you have your units. The formula can be used to derive our area of a circle, a equals pi r squared formula that we always use. So if you have, or if you're taking the area of an entire circle, that means that theta is going to be 2 pi because that's one revolution. So then you end up with your pi r squared. The biggest thing to remember on these is make sure that you're always in radians whenever you're using this formula. The last piece of this is circular motion. So linear speed versus what we call angular speed. So here's some formulas. Go ahead and pause the video and write these formulas down. So linear speed is how fast something is traveling over time, how far a car is driving, all that kind of stuff. Angular speed is how fast it's actually turning. So linear speed would be how fast it's moving over time. Angular speed would be how fast the angle is changing. So if we have a child that's spinning a rock at the end of a 2-foot rope at a rate of 180 revolutions per minute, find the linear speed of the rock. So they are giving us how fast it's spinning. So they are giving us omega, our angular speed. That little W thing is omega. They're giving us omega in revolutions per minute. Remember, all of these formulas always take theta to be in radians. So if we want to find our velocity, our linear speed, okay, it's r times omega, but first we have to find omega in radians per minute instead of revolutions per minute. So go ahead and pause the video. Remember, there are 2 pi radians in every 1 revolution. Pause the video, convert revolutions per minute into radians per minute, and then find the linear speed of the rock. So if we convert 180 revolutions per minute, it becomes 3600 pi radians per minute. And then, so that's our angular speed in radians per minute. And then if we plug that into our linear speed, which is just the radius times our angular speed, You get 2 feet times 3,600 pi radians per minute, and your linear speed is 7,200 pi feet per minute. The reason we don't have to cancel out radians is kind of what we call a non-unit. You don't need to cancel it out. Normally, we don't even write radians when we're talking about radians. There is really no unit to it. That's the nice thing. That's why we like to use radians, is so we don't have to worry about always have to cancel it like we do with degrees. So you don't need to worry about canceling it. It's just feet times radians per minute. It's just feet per minute. Just leave it in terms of pi. There's no reason to plug this into your calculator. That's your final answer.